Hi, this is Jen Lasser with Adobe Analytics Product Management. In this video, I'm going to walk through how to add dropdowns in Analysis Workspace to any panel. Dropdowns are a great way to add controlled interactions to a project for either deep dive analysis or sharing to others. You can also use dropdowns to consolidate your panels, which will lead to improved processing times in your project. To add a dropdown, simply select any component in the left rail and drag it into the panel drop zone. While holding the Shift keyboard modifier, drop the components. This will turn those components into a dropdown rather than a segment like it has in the past. Building segments in this drop zone is also still possible. The dropdown can then be expanded by clicking the chevron, and you'll see all the different component options that you added to it. As you select different options in the dropdown, it changes all the data in the panel below. You can also choose to not filter through that dropdown by choosing No Filter. The dropdowns that you add also have a customizable title. So if you wanted to change this to something like Select a Page to help narrate to your end users, you can certainly do that. You can also remove the dropdown title by simply clicking the X. Multiple dropdowns can be added to a panel. For example, if you wanted to also slice this data by marketing channel, you can bring in a marketing channel dropdown. Simply drag over those components and drop them while holding Shift. This will create a second dropdown that you can see here, lets you change the data below by marketing channel. Dropdown controls can be created for other component types as well. Date ranges are another component that you can add to the drop zone to allow a user to toggle between important date ranges that you have for your analysis. Dragging these over while holding Shift and dropping them in the drop zone, we can create a date range dropdown filter. This allows your end users to filter between different time ranges. These time ranges, just like when they're used in tables and other parts of a panel, will always override the panel date range you see in the top right. Another great idea for dropdowns is to bring in segments. So you can bring over, for example, mobile and tablet customers and drop that in the drop zone while holding Shift to allow your users to toggle between tablet and mobile customers. Lastly, I wanted to point out a component color change we've made. Rather than turning all the components that are dropped into this drop zone blue, we are now maintaining the component colors that they have. For example, dimension items will remain yellow, dates will remain purple, and segments will remain blue. If we were to drop in metrics in here, those would remain green as well. Now, the drop zone will still create hit segments under the hood for these items, and you can modify those items as needed. For example, if I were to drag over a metric of online orders and drop it in to create a segment like I have in the past, I can always edit this segment by simply clicking on the preview here and choosing the edit pencil. We're really excited to bring this feature to Analysis Workspace. Remember to use dropdowns to simplify your project work, improve project performance, and provide users of your project with a way to interact in a more controlled way.